Welcome. My name is Leah, and this is Restorative Yin. So we get to kind of play with that edge or lack of edge. So I'm going to give options for poses so that you do feel an edge as if you're doing a traditional yin class. If you want that good deep stretch, you'll have the opportunity for that, absolutely. But if you're here just to more relax and get some guided meditation and some real feel-good stuff, you can lose the edge and have full support. So just know that you've got options today. This is your practice, and I'm just here for you. So with that being said, I would like you to get started in the most comfortable position that you can think of. Think of it as our first Shavasana. And really, it's going to help us learn how to make our last Shavasana of the period or of the class even better, even juicier, even more relaxing. So go ahead and start now by laying down, by supporting beneath the knees, back, letting the forehead be a little higher than the chin, so a slight tuck of the chin. That might mean a little extra support under the head. Demonstrate a couple ways how to get super comfy. I myself do have a bolster. If you do not, you can use rolled up beach towels, you can use couch cushions. There are all sorts of ways to mimic these yoga props that we have. So I just happen to have the actual things. So that's what I'm going to use. But I'm setting up sort of a recliner chair ramp here. And then I'm just going to lay myself against it, and then you'll notice I have a mountain of blankets, so maybe I'll use those under my legs. And just like that, now I have my own little Shavasana set up as well. And while you lay here, while you lay where you are, just begin to notice everything that's in your awareness. Sounds that you hear. Maybe sounds coming from your body, sounds on your mat, breath or digestion, sounds from inside your room. Maybe you have a fan blowing. Then begin to keep widening that periphery, going further and further away from yourself, looking for things that you can hear, things you can notice. And then begin to watch them as they come into that awareness. Reaction to them. Greeting each one and letting it go as it softens and blurs into the background of your practice. Noticing all of the sounds that you may hear, but don't right now. So perhaps you know that someone's going to be coming home soon and the front door is going to be opening. Check that off the mental list. If it's possible, a neighbor's dog might bark or something else. Giving yourself permission to put yourself on airplane mode here. You are on do not disturb. All of those other things can come and go. They can happen around you. For this time, you just get to be the peace and the quiet. Notice anything else there is to notice. Any images, remnants of conversation or situations in your mind. Notice how does the air feel on your skin? Is it warm? Is it cool? Can you feel the boundary of your skin? The weight of fabric on your body? And the support of props beneath your body supporting you? Deep inhale through the nose, feel sensation in the nostrils. Exhale, get a little softer, a little heavier onto the props that are supporting you. Make any adjustments that you need to make. Inhale sensation in the nose. Exhale, sigh it out, sensation in the throat, the mouth. Getting heavier and heavier. More and more supported by the ground, by props, by the breath. Beginning to lose your shape, that boundary of the skin where it meets the air. It's all softening. And begin noticing a feeling of warmth covering the body as if sunshine is shining on you. You begin to recognize that warmth as kindness. Kindness being poured or drizzled all over you, soaking in, feeling really nice. Imagining a time in your life where you experienced true kindness. Be a kind act that you did, perhaps something kind that someone else did for you. Welcoming this memory and any other thoughts that arise. Cleansing breath in. And a clearing breath out. Blink the eyes open and take in everything that's around you, everything that you can see without moving the neck or moving the body. What's in your view? What kinds of colors, shapes? And as you're ready, you can begin to welcome some movement back to the body. Moving through the hands and the feet, the ankles and the wrists. Feeling yourself grounded now, ready to start your practice of either yin or restorative or a combination, whatever serves you best. And as you invite this movement in, can you continue that feeling of kindness? Inviting in love, perhaps even forgiveness, all of the good things, letting this be a nourishing practice. Then you can move your props just gently out of the way, but within reach. We're going to come back to them. And I would like you to begin taking inventory of the body. What are you noticing that the body could use right now? Be some movement more through the wrist if you'd like to sit up like I am. I came to a seated position, but you can keep laying down. Maybe you want to take up more space. You want to reach as high as you can and then bring the arms down. You can do this again, laying down, inhaling to reach and exhaling, the arms coming by the hips. If you'd like to come to a seated position, in fact, I recommend that you do. Everyone, go ahead and meet me seated. Seated in a comfortable way. If you'd like to sit on blocks or blankets to help elevate the hips and be more comfortable, definitely do that. I always support comfort to take care of the body you have. And from here, we're just going to do 6 movements of the spine, just to help get us ready for stillness in our posture. So let's inhale. And lift up through the top of the head. So a slight tuck up the chin. If you'd like to reach the arms up, you certainly can, but you don't have to. We're gonna let the right hand come down to the side. So you might even need a block if your sit bones or your seat is up higher, it might be good to have some help make your arms longer too. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna begin to reach the left arm up and over and get that side body stretch. Keep pulling the left shoulder back, letting it feel good, staying here as long as you need to, and then with the breath coming back up through center and taking your stretch to the other side, opening up, maybe moving through that shoulder. Doing this one more time on each side. So another time over to the right, another time over to the left. Now as we come up, we're gonna grow a bit taller again and we're gonna twist towards the right. Back through center, twist towards the left. One more time each side. Maybe going a little bit deeper, maybe pulling it back. With your breath, with your movement. And now we're gonna find some spinal flexion and extension. You can do this seated. Inhale, maybe you drag the hands back towards the hips and lift the heart, maybe even lift the chin. You can slide the hands back towards the knees, round the back, hollow the front of the body, and tuck the chin. Moving through these seated cat-cows with the breath. I'll turn this way so you can see my spine. So inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale, and you'll notice that you feel the air mostly in the front side of the body. You're inhaling forward, expanding this way, exhaling, letting it go. If you'd like to mix it up, if you'd like to try to breathe into the back of the body, let's try to switch it up a little bit. Let's inhale into the back of the body. Let's imagine we're filling the backs of the lungs. Exhale, bring it forward. Inhale, exhale. And if you'd like to come onto hands and knees now, get a little bit deeper with this, you certainly can. Again, moving with the breath, it doesn't matter where you're inhaling, where you're exhaling for these purposes, just as long as you're moving with your breath. Letting the breath initiate the movement as well. We're not trying to create heat or energy. We're just stirring up what's already present. Trying to help it cool down. And then allow yourself to take any other movements that feel natural for you, that feel needed. Perhaps that's stretching through the wrists, turning the fingertips back and the palms up, swaying the hips side to side. We're going to move into our heart melt pose from here. So when you're ready, and if you'd like to use some support, grab your support. I'll demonstrate with my bolster what that can look like. So I'm going to demonstrate first traditional heart melt. So we start in our tabletop, and then you just begin to, you keep the hips stacked over the knees, and you begin to walk the hands forward so that the heart begins to bow down, the heart melts towards the floor. Now this might be pretty intense, especially coming all the way chest down. That may not be the best yin posture if you're looking for a very delicate edge. So that's why I would say using some support can be very helpful. You can put the bolster in front of you, again, keeping the hips over the knees, walking the hands forward. And when you begin to feel the stretch through the arms, the shoulders, the chest, it might be somewhere different for you depending on your anatomy and what you've been doing. But walk the hands forward, bow the chest down, and let there be some support. You can turn your head in one direction or the other, or tuck the chin and be forehead down, or you can stretch through the front of the throat and the gaze be forward. Just be careful with your cervical spine. We don't want any crunching going on back there or kinks. So it may be best to turn the head. The bolster may also be a compromise for you if you don't need that full support of the bolster, or whatever you're using as a bolster. You can use something similar to a block, something similar in size and support. And perhaps you find your heart melt with the chest still coming down, but only the forehead is supported. So you can still use the energy, the directional pull towards the earth through the underarms. And again, let it feel good. This is your time for self-care, to refill your cup, to give yourself loving kindness. And as you're in this heart melt, I'd like to offer you a mantra for your practice. That mantra is, only love lives within me. Only love lives within me. I'm saying it now in your own voice, in your own head. Only love lives within me. It doesn't mean that bad stuff doesn't happen or we don't get in bad moods, but our essence is love. That's what it's all about. So let this mantra almost be like a goal. You can even let this mantra help form an intention for your practice. Only love lives within me. And in your practice today, allow yourself to love yourself fully. To slither forward all the way onto your belly. Now, if you have a prop beneath you, you may want to use it for our next pose. We're going to find our Sphinx pose. A supported Sphinx is an amazing Sphinx. So I'm going to demonstrate that first, and then I'll demonstrate the traditional. So assuming I had my bolster for my puppy pose or my heart melt, I would just turn it so it was perpendicular to my mat, and then I would lay my rib cage on top. And so now I don't really have any weight going on in the shoulders, but I still have this nice little back bend back here. I'm just gonna scooch my stuff aside. Here we go. So in my supported Sphinx, I'm right here. I'm able to spread the collarbones apart and pull the shoulder blades together and then down the spine. If you'd like some support for the forehead, a block is really great here. You can either place it on the bolster, or if you're not using a bolster, place it on the floor. Tuck the chin, lengthen the back of the neck, and rest the head. Or if you'd like something with a little bit more of an edge, again, we're respecting our edges. We're not gonna go too far. If you'd like more, you can take away the bolster, take away the pillows, come all the way to the belly. Elbows under shoulders. Again, find a lift of the heart. And then the same option to support the head. Just keep pulling the collarbones, the outer edges of the collarbones, apart from each other. And then the shoulders away from the ears. Noticing what you notice, that you feel in this shape. Where is the sensation different than the last posture? Where is it similar? Are there any similarities? Buddha says, you yourself, as much as anyone in the entire universe, deserves your love and affection. So it's not always about giving love, giving giving affection, but we've got to give it to ourselves as well. We need it. During this first posture of this type of meditation we're doing, I'd like you to think about yourself. Your opinions of yourself, your views. We can often be way too harsh on ourselves. We nitpick. But instead, can you try to have a softer vision of yourself? Kinder eyes. Try to see yourself as your best friend sees you. And then separating yourself from yourself, can you say these words to yourself? May you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you have a life of ease. Letting those words soak in. And now lay all the way flat on your belly, completely pronated. And you can make a pillow for your forehead, come off of any props that you're on, and then bend the knees and sway the heels from side to side, neutralizing through the low back. Maybe drawing circles through the feet, rolling through the ankles, whatever feels good. And to neutralize, we're gonna find a half frog. So keeping the legs long, we're gonna cactus the arms and turn our gaze towards the left and begin to bend the left knee and draw it up as if we're gonna try and knee ourselves with our left knee to our left elbow. You can let that leg come out as wide as you need to away from the midline. We're not here for very long, so again, notice what you notice. What do you enjoy about this pose? Is there anything that you don't enjoy about it? Allowing there to be positive and negative feelings at the same time. Only here for about one more minute. So try to slow the breath down. Straightening through the left leg now, turning the gaze towards the right, and then bending through the right knee as you draw it up alongside the right hip, finding your half frog on the right side. Only here for a couple of minutes. Again, find things to enjoy about the shape, to enjoy about you, your body in the shape. How is this helpful to you? Three more breaths. then you're going to come back to center, and you're going to come back to your sphinx-like shape. So elbows under shoulders, and we're not going to be here for very long. We're going to do our broken branches pose. So take the right hand, and you're going to slip it behind the left elbow, and bring the right shoulder down towards the ground. Notice if your left ear, the left temple, if the right ear or the right temple can come down to the floor. It might need some cushioning. You can use a blanket or a pillow. Notice where you feel sensation or stretch, maybe in the back of that right shoulder. If you need more, you can try to rotate the chest more forward and then reach through the hand. Also take the left hand and bring it behind the back. Again, being mindful of your edge. That first bit of talking that the body does when it notices stress in the body. Tissues being stretched, tested. That's where we stop. When the body learns that we will honor its limits, it'll give us a little more. That's how we get more and more flexible. It's really about training the nervous system. And now, coming to the other side, so resetting. And this time, the left hand goes under the space of the right arm. And the left shoulder comes down, maybe a pillow for the head. And just like the other side, we're not here for very long. Notice the breath. Is it coming easy? Does it feel forced? Are you enjoying it? To find a combination, twisted branches. So coming back up to our Sphinx pose, and I'd like you to bring your left elbow to the center, and you're going to cross your right arm over on top of the left. Then you're going to spider crawl the fingers out wide, and then begin to walk them apart. Notice if it would feel good to have a block or a pillow of some sort for the forehead as you begin to walk the hands apart, just like I'm demonstrating. Maybe you can give yourself a big hug and feel the shoulder blades on your back body. You can even lightly massage yourself here. And then coming all the way back up, getting ready for the other side. This time the right arm comes in the center and the left arm crosses over. You begin to spider crawl the fingers wide so the hands can reach in opposite directions. Maybe give yourself a hug, or maybe the hands keep reaching. Let the back of the neck be nice and smooth, no creases or wrinkles. Maybe a little palpations, massage, touch. And release the arms. And you have the option to stay in your Sphinx pose now, or to begin pressing into the hands and finding a seal shape. Deeper back bend. You can hang into the arms if you like. That's just a wood element. That's okay. You can also do the supported by bringing that bolster or some blankets under the rib cage for some support. And this time, I'd like you to think about someone that you love. I'm not going to ask you to pick your favorite person, but pick a person, someone who you have loving feelings towards. It doesn't have to be romantic. Envisioning this person, their clothes, their hair, their smile. Just like you, they need, want, and adore love. Everyone, it's a human need. So thinking about this person that you love, that needs love, say to them, may you be safe. May you be healthy. May you live a life of ease. And now let your palms plant and then push your chest up through the table and find a child's pose. It might feel really nice on the low back about now. You're going to feel a stretch from the low back, maybe through the glutes. So be aware of that. If you'd like support, you can definitely bring some support in front of you and rest the chest that way. You can bring the knees together or apart. There's really no right or wrong way to do a child's pose. Just do the one that feels good for your body. Allow yourself to really melt into this child's pose. Letting it be a pose of comfort, of ease, of safety. Notice any feelings, any thoughts coming up. Without judgment, just observing. And now think about someone that you are completely neutral with. It can be someone you've never even spoken to, but that you've seen regularly enough. Someone, the local business, the bus stop, store, maybe another yoga teacher that you've done their classes online, someone that you can visualize, you can see their face. You're not sure what they do in their free time or what their interests or goals are, what they hope to become, not like the person that you love, not like yourself, you know those things. But this neutral person, kind of mysterious. Maybe you can imagine their smile. Maybe you can imagine the sound of their voice if you've ever heard it, but maybe not. But recognize that they too, like you, like the people you love, need love. They need kindness. So with this person in your mind, may you be happy, may you be safe, may you be healthy, may you live a life of ease. Repeating it two more times, from you to them. And maybe they'll feel this love and this kindness, they'll receive it. Maybe I feel just a little bit lighter this evening, a little bit warmer in the heart space. Sending love and kindness and well wishes for someone who you have no real attachment to. And just seeing what that does for you inside. Those good things. On hands and knees and move the hips from side to side. Now we're going to enter it this way. So from our table, we are going to bring the left knee to the center, just like we did for that broken branches with our arms crossed, the twisted roots. Bring the left knee to center and then cross the right knee behind the left. And you're going to spread your feet wide enough. So as you begin to sit back, you can place a block or other support beneath your seat, or you can sit on the floor between the heels, depending on the availability of space in your body. Our shoelace pose, and you can Goldilocks it. If you need to come back up, if you think, oh, I can sit here, but the more I'm here and the more uncomfortable I get, this is beyond my edge, just lean forward enough. Stick something under the seat and you'll get a little bit higher. If that's still not doing it for you, if this is just too intense, lean onto the right hip and straighten the right leg. So do half shoelace. Okay? Deep breath in and a deep breath out. Option to stay just as you are, spine stacked or maybe melted forward. Or we can find some eagle arms. Reaching the arms out, crossing the right arm over the left, and then wrapping the arms, maybe backs of the hands to each other, maybe palms to each other, maybe just giving yourself a hug. Finding a little lift of the elbows, a little pull away from the chest, stretching the backs of the shoulders. Noticing if at any time you need to adjust, and then making those adjustments. A good way to be kind and loving to yourself is to honor your body, its needs. Noticing what the body needs, how you can love on it. Only love lives within me. With your exhales, let anything else that's not loving go, just for now. You see what that does for you. Deep breath in and deep breath out. We're going to exit this pose. You can do it one of two ways. You can rock forward on the hands and knees and uncross the legs, shift the hips side to side, do some cat-cows, or you can lean onto the right hip, slide the leg long, lean towards the left, slide the leg long, kind of like the cha-cha slide. Hands plant behind the hips and you can windshield wiper here. Again, there's no right, there's no wrong. Just what feels right or wrong, and that's what matters. When you're ready, we're going to do the other side. So we can come back and do this from our table, or you can do this seated. So if you're doing it from the table, this time I believe we're crossing the right leg behind, which way? Guys, now I'm confused. Right leg to center, cross the left leg behind. Yes. So that way the right leg is on top of the left. And again, Goldilocksing it, sitting on a block, blanket. Noticing where the heels are in relation to the hips, where the knees are in relation to each other, if they're stacked, staggered, if there's lots of space or not. A lot of it just has to do with anatomy, to be honest with you. So don't get too attached to having your legs look a certain way. It's all about how it feels. That's why Yin has cute little animal names for poses that aren't very yoga-like or historic like Sanskrit. That way it loses the attachment to image. You're not expected to look any certain way in a shape in yin yoga. Instead, you just get to take on the benefits of the shapes. So from here, same options to find those eagle arms. This time left over right. Lifting up from the elbows, pulling the forearms away from the face, stretching the back. The shoulder blades pull apart. Maybe giving yourself a big hug if that feels better. Enjoying these few minutes. Feeling a little pretzel-y, a little twisty. Only love lives within me. Being fully aware that you can give love to yourself, to others, to yourself who you know very well, to someone that you love, who you know pretty well, to an acquaintance who you don't know well, but you can see in your mind. What about the other people? You know who I'm talking about. Go ahead and exit the shape, exit the pose, lean onto the left hip, the right leg slide long, and the left. Making sure that we give some time for counter movement, counter positioning. If you're in your table, do some cat cows, draw some big circles with the hips. I'd like you to find yourself in a supported fish pose, kind of a heart bench. I'm going to demonstrate it first with blocks so that you can see, and then I will show you with a bolster. So the block version is going to have one block be between the shoulder blades, ladies, where you clasp your bra, and then one for the head. You don't have to have one for the head. You could also use a pillow or just put the front of the throat open. What matters is the back of the neck. So if the cervical spine, if that's too much of a kink there, don't do that. So starting with knees bent, feeling yourself back, block between the shoulder blades, and a block for the head. Spread the collarbones apart, tuck the shoulder blades beneath you, and then let the chest really open up towards the sky. You can imagine just revealing the contents of your rib cage upwards towards the sun. Legs can do whatever you'd like them to do. Knees in towards each other, maybe finding a butterfly shape, feet together, knees apart. Feeling completely safe and comfortable in your own space to do whatever feels good for you. If you're using more of a rolled up beach towel or blankets or bolster, you have two options. You can bring that again, the bottom of the bolster representing one of the blocks to where the shoulder blades are. And then resting there, keeping the lift of the chest. Or if you'd like something a little bit different, you're going to find a seated position and bring the bolster all the way to you. And then from there, slowly recline over the bolster. Again, noticing what feels good for the legs, where you'd like them to end up. Maybe a hand over the belly and one over the chest. Maybe both hands down, shoulders roll apart and down. Noticing what you notice, feeling open, feeling receptive. We've been sending out a lot of love during this practice. Can you receive it as well? Can you think about the other yogis taking this class? Whether you know them or not, whether you can ever see them or not, know that there's other people practicing this exact same practice. Can you send them just a little bit of love? May you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live a life of ease. And now I'd like you to think of someone in your life who you've had some sort of conflict with. And it can be very minor. We don't need to go into anything deep, nothing triggering, but someone who you've put some sort of a block or barricade between emotionally. And it could be a very healthy barricade or block or restriction or boundary. In fact, boundaries are some of the best gifts that we can give. But I'd like you to have this person in mind, someone who you generally maybe even would say dislike or have poor feelings towards. And again, they can be completely valid. That's not what we're working over here. What we're working with, what we're trying to work through and over and under and everything in between, is can we send love to someone who we have negative feelings towards, who we've had negative experiences with? It is a challenge. But I'd like you to see that person in your mind. Notice the ab reaction that you're having. Maybe you're having a bad reaction. You think, oh, I don't want my chest to be so open here. Oh, I don't want to be so vulnerable. That's okay. You can put a blanket over you. But I'm going to ask you to challenge yourself. Have a heart open posture. Think about the person who's troubled you. And then set yourself aside for just a moment, knowing that you're still here. You're still important. Your love and happiness matters very much. And for that reason, for your happiness, begin to send this person who you have negative feelings towards, or you have boundaries or barricades, blocks between, send them the same thoughts, the same feelings we've been sending everyone else. May you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live a life of ease. Two more times on your own, letting this be cathartic, letting it be cleansing, maybe even providing some closure, wishing them well, to send them on their way, so that what you're left with is kindness in your heart. And openness and lightness. And now come back into the self. Notice how you feel. What thoughts are present? What images or memories are raising through the body to the crown or lowering down to the feet? Everything that's arising is welcome. You soften just a little bit. Let my voice be your voice. repeating to yourself, I deserve to be safe. I deserve to be happy. I deserve to be healthy. I deserve to live a life of ease. Only love lives within me. Letting that soak through all of your layers as if it was a tree or a plant with dry soil that just got watered. Watered with love and affirmation, with truth. Sometimes it takes a little while for that water to absorb all the way down so that the roots can be nourished. Give yourself time. Repeating any of it back to yourself that you need to repeat. Noticing now if the body could be any more comfortable, if it needs some movement. And go ahead and take that, maybe bend the knees, labral vibrathum. Maybe and come up off of your prop, your blocks, your bolster, whatever you had. Move it to the side and find a pose again of comfort, hugging the knees into the chest, compression. Maybe even tucking the chin up, making yourself into a little tiny safe ball. As small as you can get. Imagine yourself like a little pearl, nice and round, beautiful. Made beautiful by friction, by challenge. Allow your body to again soften towards the ground. Stretch the arms and legs apart to reaching the arms overhead and the feet. As you get longer and longer, maybe move through the ankles and the wrists. Begin to think about how you'd like to spend your Shavasana. Getting as comfortable as possible. Reflecting upon that first position that you took, that first starting Shavasana of the practice. And noting any ways that you can improve your comfort level. Maybe more pillows, blankets. Take your time setting up. There's absolutely no rush. But do get comfortable. You deserve it. You were able to send yourself love, kindness. You were able to send that to someone you care deeply about, to an acquaintance, and to the other person. It's a job well done. With that, I'm going to play some sounds on the harmonium. I hope that you enjoy the sounds and that they are relaxing to you. If you don't really enjoy the harmonium, this might be a good time to turn the volume down. Otherwise, just allow yourself, your body to soften, the mind to even soften. Finding yourself completely at ease.
Thank you.
a deep breath in and a smooth breath out. Inviting in warmth, softness, alertness to the body and the mind. The mind, possibly by opening the eyes, taking in all the sights. To the body by moving it, by stretching or reaching, by rolling or flexing and extending. Waking the body and the mind up completely. Only love lives within me. If only for this practice, but acknowledging that perhaps a seed was planted. That seed will be watered, will grow. So maybe you'll even be in a situation where someone makes you really irritated. You can repeat to yourself, to them, may you be safe, may you be happy, may you be healthy, may you live a life of ease. And let that person right out of your mind. Join me seated. You can sit again any way that's comfortable. There's no rush. We are going to find community one more time with our breath, so bring palms together. Anjali Mudra. So palms press in, reach tall through the crown and tuck through the chin. Deep inhale. And exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Last time together, breathe in. And let it go. Namaste. Thank you guys so much. Such a gift to be able to lead a practice. So thank you.